Okay, guys, let's see the newest Google keynote of the Google I.O. 2024 together.
Hi, everyone. Good morning. Welcome to Google I.O. It's great to have all of you with us. We have a few thousand developers with us here today at Shoreline. Millions more are joining virtually around the world. Thanks to everyone for being here. For those of you who haven't seen I.O. before, it's basically Google's version of the Era Store, but with fewer costume changes. At Google, though, we are fully in our Gemini era. You'll hear a lot about that today. Before we get into it, I want to reflect on this moment we are in. We've been investing in AI for more than a decade and innovating at every layer of the stack, research, product, infrastructure. We're going to talk about it all today. Still, we are in the very early days of the AI platform shift. We see so much opportunity ahead for creators, for developers, for startups, for everyone. Helping to drive those opportunities is what our Gemini era is all about. So let's get started. A year ago on this stage, we first shared our plans for Gemini, a frontier model built to be natively multimodal from the very beginning that could reason across text, images, video, code, and more. It's a big step in turning any input into any output, an I.O. for a new generation. Since then, we introduced the first Gemini models, our most capable yet. They demonstrated state-of-the-art performance on every multimodal benchmark, and that was just the beginning. 2 months later, we introduced Gemini 1.5 Pro, delivering a big breakthrough in long context. It can run 1 million tokens in production consistently, more than any other large-scale foundation model yet. We want everyone to benefit from what Gemini can do. So we have worked quickly to share these advances with all of you. Today, more than 1.5 million developers use Gemini models across our tools. You're using it to debug code, get new insights, and to build the next generation of AI applications. We've also been bringing Gemini's breakthrough capabilities across our products in powerful ways. We'll show examples today across search, photos, workspace, Android, and more. Today, all of our 2 billion user products use Gemini. And we've introduced new experiences too, including on mobile, where people can interact with Gemini directly through the app. Now available on Android and iOS, and through Gemini Advanced, which provides access to our most capable models. Over 1 million people have signed up to try it in just 3 months, and it continues to show strong momentum. One of the most exciting transformations with Gemini has been in Google Search. In the past year, we've answered billions of queries as part of our search generative experience. People are using it to search in entirely new ways and asking new types of questions, longer and more complex queries, even searching with photos, and getting back the best the web has to offer. We've been testing this experience outside of labs, and we are encouraged to see not only an increase in search usage, but also an increase in user satisfaction. I'm excited to announce that we will begin launching this fully revamped experience, AI Overviews, to everyone in the US this week, and we'll bring it to more countries soon. There's so much innovation happening in search. Thanks to Gemini, we can create much more powerful search experiences, including within our products. Let me show you an example in Google Photos. We launched Google Photos almost 9 years ago. Since then, people have used it to organize their most important memories. Today, that amounts to more than 6 billion photos and videos uploaded every single day. And people love using photos to search across their life. With Gemini, you're making that a whole lot easier. Say you're at a parking station ready to pay, but you can't recall your license plate number. Before, you could search photos for keywords and then scroll through years' worth of photos looking for the right one. Now, you can simply ask photos. It knows the cars that appear often, it triangulates which one is yours, and just tells you the license plate number. And ask photos can also help you search your memories in a deeper way. For example, you might be reminiscing about your daughter Lucia's early milestones. You can ask photos, when did Lucia learn to swim?
And my first reaction was, there's no way they were able to achieve this.
I wanted to test its technical skills. So I uploaded a line chart. It was temperatures between like Tokyo and Berlin and how they vary across the 12 months of the year.
So I got in there and I threw in the Python library that I was really struggling with. And I just asked it a simple question. And it nailed it. It could find specific references to comments in the code and specific requests that people had made and other issues that people had had, but then suggest a fix for it that related to what I was working on.
I immediately tried to kind of crash it. So I took, you know, 4 or 5 research papers I had on my desktop. And it's a mind-blowing experience when you add so much text and then you see the kind of amount of tokens you add is not even at half the capacity.
It felt a little bit like Christmas because you saw things kind of peppered up to the top of your feed about like, oh wow, I built this thing. Or, oh, it's doing this and I would have never expected.
Can I shoot a video of my possessions and turn that into a searchable database? So I ran to my bookshelf and I shot a video just panning my camera along the bookshelf and I fed the video into the model. It gave me the titles and authors of the books, even though the authors weren't visible on those book spines. And on the bookshelf, there was a squirrel nutcracker sat in front of the book, truncating the title. You could just see the word Site C, and it still guessed the correct book. The range of things you can do with that is almost unlimited.
And so at that point, for me, it was just like a click, like, this is it.
I thought like I had like a superpower in my hands.
It was poetry. It was beautiful. I was so happy. It just, this is going to be amazing. This is going to help people.
This is kind of where the future of language models are going. Personalized to you, not because you trained it to be personal to you, but personal to you because you can give it such a vast understanding of who you are.
We've been rolling out Gemini 1.5 Pro with long context and preview over the last few months. We've made a series of quality improvements across translation, coding, and reasoning. You'll see these updates reflected in the model starting today. I'm excited to announce that we are bringing this improved version of Gemini 1.5 Pro to all developers globally. In addition today, Gemini 1.5 Pro with 1 million contexts is now directly available for consumers in Gemini Advanced and can be used across 35 languages. 1 million tokens is opening up entirely new possibilities. It's exciting, but I think we can push ourselves even further. So today, we are expanding the context window to 2 million tokens. We are making it available for developers in private preview. It's amazing to look back and see just how much progress we have made in a few months. This represents the next step on our journey towards the ultimate goal of infinite context. Okay, so far we have talked about two technical advances, multimodality and long context. Each is powerful on its own, but together they unlock deeper capabilities and more intelligence. Let's see how this comes to life with Google Workspace. People are always searching their emails in Gmail. We are working to make it much more powerful with Gemini. Let's look at how. As a parent, you want to know everything that's going on with your child's school. Okay, maybe not everything, but you want to stay informed. Gemini can help you keep up. Now we can ask Gemini to summarize all recent emails from the school. In the background, it's identifying relevant emails, even analyzing attachments like PDFs, and you get a summary of the key points and action items. So helpful. Maybe you were traveling this week and you couldn't make the PTA meeting. The recording of the meeting is an hour long. If it's from Google Meet, you can ask Gemini to give you the highlights. There's a parents group looking for volunteers. You're free that day. Of course, Gemini can draft a reply. There are countless other examples of how this can make life easier. Gemini 1.5 Pro is available today in Workspace Labs, and Aparna will share more later on. We just looked at an example with text outputs, but with a multimodal model, we can do so much more. To show you an early demo of an audio output in Notebook LM, here's Josh.